Hi hotties! I would say that fashion is like a really big part of my life, and so is this YouTube channel. And the way that I haven't posted a fashion video in 5 months is actually really heartbreaking. So I have a very, very collective haul. There's a lot of stuff right here, and I wanted to show you all the pieces that I picked up recently to get me prepped for the new year. I can't believe 2023 is coming, but all I know is that I want to dress hot and I want to feel sexy. Let's go. We're gonna start off with some crop tops because y'all know I love me a little crop top, okay? A little baby tee action. I've been really into tops that cut like kind of below your belly button, like a little peak of the little button. I think it kind of gives very like model off duty, even though your girl's not a model, but I can cosplay as one, I can dress up as one, and I really love this red color, which is so funny because even in my apartment, I feel like there's a lot of splashes of red, but red has never been my favorite color ever. I don't even know why I have like a weird vendetta against red, but at the same time, literally everything in my life is red. I got this baby off Depop, and the tag says Gucci. I don't know. I don't think it's like the Gucci that we all know, but y'all are gonna catch me saying like, oh, I have a Gucci shirt, like it's whatever. This one has a really similar cut, but I really love the sheer sleeves that it has going on. I think it really adds something, and I love the green color because I think it matches well with my hair, and a lot of people say whenever I wear green with this hair color that I look like Kim Possible, and I'm just gonna take that as a compliment because she was one of my like little cartoon crushes growing up, second to Shigo. Y'all know this is not a Jasmine Lee video if I don't talk about K-pop, but I also saw that my bias in Le Sserafim, Yeonjun, was wearing this, and I bought it before like I saw that, and I was like, oh my god, our minds. So whenever I wear this, I'm like, I'm basically an idol right now. Really, really love, like, isn't this so interesting? I think it adds a little pop, but the thing is that this is all in French, and your girl cannot read French, okay? There was a time when I was in fourth grade and I really wanted to learn French because one of my friends like spoke French and I thought it was really cool. And that lasted probably a week, so can't read this. Let me know what it says. Hopefully it's nothing bad. We all know Bella Hadid and how she's been a fashion icon, especially this year. I don't know why I feel like Bella Hadid would wear this even though it's like literally from Princess Polly. Like, I don't think she'd wear in Princess Polly. I think it's like a little fun top. I kind of had a lot of basics this year because I usually didn't wear a lot of basics before, and now I do, so I had to stock up my closet with this. But I thought I'd go back to like my 90s Y2K route with this. If you watched my last video, y'all know this shirt and how much I love it. It's a kind of jersey inspired tee, and I really, really love the fit of this. It's not too tight and it's not too revealing. I really don't have a lot of tops that are like this kind of simple and boxy. I think this is my favorite purchase of the year actually, and it's kind of giving bloke. Like bloquette. I don't know, I think I saw a TikTok about it. It's like very like British. That was really embarrassing to say because I know I said it wrong because I don't have an accent. Kind of like dressing it up, making it very girly in contrast with this kind of very sporty vibe. Y'all know I'm obsessed with pucca and my pucca shirt, so I grabbed another one, and this time it's in a black color. It is a bit longer than what I would usually go for, but I really love the print, and oh my god, the back is really what sold me. I think if it was just like this, it was just kind of like, you know, bam. I don't think I've ever seen a top like this, or maybe just like workout clothes that kind of have this cutout, but I thought it was so fucking dope. And the last little tee that I have is this little realization par one. I feel like it was very trendy a few years ago, but I finally got my hands on it. The fit and cut is very basic, which I really like, but the print is pretty eye-catching, but not too much. You know what I mean? I think it's toeing the line a little. Moving on to tank tops, and if you've been watching me for a while, I think you would know that I've been kind of going through body confidence issues. Like, I was really insecure with my arms, so I would just never wear tank tops, and I felt like that really closed me off on really expressing myself in the way that I wanted to fashion-wise. So I have some basics here to kind of help me a little bit, and I've been wearing these a lot, actually. I have the same little top in black and white, and I think the cut and the fit is absolutely perfect. I feel really, really good in these. And also, they have like an inner liner right here. So I still like sometimes like to wear pasties under, but it's not really necessary. And I kind of like that extra coverage and little support. I've been kind of liking embracing how kind of basic they are. Sometimes I'll just wear it as its own and then wear it with like a pretty basic bottom. I felt like before I was going a little bit crazy with the prints, but also don't get me wrong, I will just use this as like kind of like baseline and layer a lot of things on top of it. So I think that's the whole thing of like having little basics. Another little tank top is one that I'm wearing right now. I try to match my lips to theirs. It's not as red. I just didn't think I wanted to go full red today, but the vibes are there. I really didn't have any tank tops that were this high cut. I think it's very flattering. It looks kind of sophisticated a little. The material on this is so stretchy and it is definitely one of the most comfortable tank tops I've ever worn. I really didn't expect this kind of like fabric when I bought it initially, but when I put it on, I was like, this is it. And while the entire top is basically a print, I wouldn't say it's too busy, color-wise at least. Like, I think it's very like neutral right here, and then like the pops of red, which y'all know I really like my clothing pieces. Next up is this tank top. It has a square neckline, which none of my other tank tops do, and I think it's really flattering. It's a little bit more basic looking because it's white, and it also has red, which we've already discussed. I guess I like in my clothes. In my opinion, the price was a bit steep initially when I looked at it, but then when I like read the like text right here, it says super real. And if y'all don't know by now, these boobies right here, I paid for. They're fake. So I thought it was kind of funny if I like wore it right here and it says super real, when these are not super real. I also have this little tube top and I absolutely wear it to death because I think it's such a great little basic. It doesn't have any prints, but it has a little bit of an interesting flair to it because of like the fabric design. I love the color. I think it matches with almost everything. Moving on to long sleeves, I just have one. It's a black off the shoulder top and I really like it because it has like ruched detailing right here. The sleeves are a bit long and flared. I feel very whimsical in this. I think everyone by now has watched the Netflix show Wednesday, so I feel like a little bit Morticia? Am I giving Morticia? Am I giving MILF? It's a little bit sophisticated, kind of, but also pretty sexy. Going off of my ongoing body confidence journey, this year I finally started wearing skirts, and I actually made a TikTok about this, and I mentioned it in a girl talk recently, but I was pretty insecure about my legs, and I just also never wore skirts. I just felt like they never looked good on me. I never felt good in them, but then one morning I was like, you know what? I can do this. So I like found one skirt that I had and I wore it out and I felt good. So I decided to treat myself with some more because I mean, I can't just keep wearing the same skirt all the time. The first one is this little cargo mini skirt and I really like the like detailing right here. I think it's very visually interesting to look at. Again, love the green with the orange. I think it's a great, not so basic basic to have. Y'all, when I tell you I found my skirt, like the skirt that I love so much. If I ever need to just feel kind of better about myself, I will throw this baby on. It is so, so nice. I love the material of it, which I feel like initially I didn't think that I would like because I feel like when you're looking for, especially denim basics, you want it to be kind of tough. So then it will last you for years and years and years. But I would say that this is kind of stretchy and I really just like that. I think it makes my little booty look kind of cute. It kind of floats up. It looks so high and cute. I don't know. I will take it to the grave with me. Imagine me in my like little casket. Actually, I don't even know if I want to be in a casket because I feel like that is so expensive. Like, just burn me up, I guess. But also, imagine me like probably like, I don't know, let's say like 90 years old wearing this skirt. That'd actually be iconic. This next piece is a skirt that even before my little like self-confidence journey, I was like, wow, I wish one day that I could wear this skirt. It looks so beautiful on so many people. I love how it looks. I'm just not confident in myself. Like, I can never wear something like that. Bam! I got it. I treated this as a little reward for me on how, like, you know, I'm feeling a bit more confident in myself. I deserve to splurge a little on a skirt, and isn't it so cool? I've never seen a skirt like this, really. It's pleated, it's gray. I love the little keychain right here. You could unzip the front parts a little to show some leg, that'd be a little sexy. But you could also push it down if you wanna be a little bit more conservative. It has a really cool like waist tie action. You can see it in the back as well, the bows. like this is such a dream, and I'm just so grateful and happy to have this in my closet and bring it with me to 2023. Alrighty, moving on to dresses. I think Skims has been one of the places to get really high quality and nice basics. So I have the iconic long ass dress from Skims. It is so long on me, and I'm just like, Kim, honey, aren't we the same height? Like, you gotta make it for us short girlies too. You know how hard it is for us to find clothes too, but it's okay. I have this one and I think I look pretty sexy in it. It hugs really well, makes my boobies look good, but it's so comfortable. I think this one actually is meant to be a lounge dress. Like, you just wear it around the house and feel nice and bougie. It's that comfortable. Like, I feel like I could really sleep in this. It's tight, but not too constricting, and I just really like it. These next two dresses are from For Love and Lemons. And if you know anything about that brand, it is so whimsical, so girly, so beautiful. And they sent a couple pieces over, and this is the first one. It's such a dream. I love me a baby doll dress. It has sheer floral fabric. The bodice right here, is that a call bodice? I think it is. But isn't it so intricate and beautiful? It has bows. If I somehow reincarnated into a dress, I think this would be me. I love spinning around in this, and it's so comfortable, but it still looks very, very classy, I think. This next one is also a baby doll dress, but it is all black, and it has really cool velvet fabric right here on the boobies. I have been in search of a little baby doll dress with the little bows right here for forever. So when I saw this, I was so grateful that they sent it to me. A really cool thing about this dress is that the inside is a bodysuit and the outside is sheer. So she's a little scandalous. She's a little, ooh, like, let's take a peek. But it's not too much. Like, your whole ass isn't out, but it's a little, it's a little feisty, but also paired with something so girly. I love the contrast. And as my mother, best dressed, would say, juxtaposition. Oh my god, I forgot about all the little pants that I got. So here we go. All of these still have the tag on them, but this first one is kind of like cargo pants, but they're a little bit tighter. But I only have one pair of tight pants, and that shit has been like through it, okay? Like, people know her. We all know her. I thought it was time to add to the family, and I really like the details, as you can see right here. I will say it is a bit long for my legs, but honestly, I don't really mind that because I am short. I usually wear platforms like exclusively. So whenever I have long pants like this, I'll just put them over my platforms. Bam. I look like I'm naturally tall because you can't even see the shoes. Life hack. It has a lot of fun pockets, which is really good for when I go out clubbing and I don't want to wear a little purse. I could just stuff it in my little booty right here, and it has a zipper. I've mentioned these jeans before in a favorites video I made last year, but I had a little accident with Mother Nature, and those jeans are no longer wearable. So I repurchased them. They're from Athens. Absolutely my favorite. They're low rise and the perfect amount of baggy. Chef's kiss. And since I was already on the website, I'm gonna wear the same kind of cut. Might as well switch up the colors. So I have this one in a different wash. Okay guys, we're almost done. I know it's a lot. Hope you guys are enjoying this video. This first one is very crinkly. This one was kind of an oddball to me, but I saw it on TikTok and I thought it was the most cool little jacket that I've ever seen. I've been really into baggy on baggy, kind of like more streetwear. I love the color because it's gray, but kind of like a little tint of green blue. I thought this would be a really cool piece to use to layer up. It's one of those jackets that zip up all the way to your neck, so you can keep your little neck warm. And I also just really like the look of it. Also has a little hood. Super cool. I'm just describing everything that is part of a jacket. This is not really a jacket because, as you can see, it's covering nothing. It's not resisting wind, rain. It's barely even covering my torso, but I think it's a really dope outerwear layering piece. I've seen Colleen Diaz wear something kind of similar to this, and I really, really like how she styled it. I wore this last night and I just threw it on the couch. So let me just, this next one provides a little bit more coverage. As you can see, it's kind of still see-through, but it's not as much as the other one. And it's green. It has a little star on it. It is so comfortable and soft. I love just throwing this on. I'm pretty sure this was originally marketed for men's, so the sleeves are very long, which I kind of like. I like going like like this. I think this is a really cool piece to either dress up or down. You can wear it with some baggy jeans, or you can do like some little shorts or a skirt. It would look completely different. And the last jacket I have is this Miss 60 one. Y'all know I love me some denim, and when they sent this to me, it was so cool. Like, I freaking love it. There's so many sequins and the back. Look at her! I don't have any denim jackets that have this kind of intricate, but still not too loud and crazy. I mean, I feel like it might be a little loud and crazy, but to my standards, isn't that that bad. She's a bit cropped too, which I think is really good because a lot of my jackets and outerwear are very large. Like, they kind of go to my mid-thigh. So I think it's good to have a top that kind of cuts at your waistline or your hip line for a change, you know. All right, last thing are shoes, and the first one I have are these Big Mamas. I initially got these because I was going to a Stray Kids concert, and I was like, okay, I'm 5'1", I'm gonna be on the floor, not gonna see anything. They are skin tight right here, and the fact that it's like a very thick bottom, like as you can see, makes it very easy to walk in, surprisingly. I mean, as easy as 6 to 7 inch heels can be, but I really, really love these. I didn't know if I would wear them too much post-concert, but I wear these so often. I wear these to the club. Literally, I will wear these to the club. All the concerts that I go to, I've been trying to dabble in streetwear, so I have these little sneakers. I don't have any black sneakers. The shoelaces are sparkly, which I think is such a fun little touch. I really like the design of the bottom right here. I don't know what this is called, but I like it. So yeah, that is my little haul. Actually, not so little haul of the clothes that I've gotten in the past few months that I really want to bring into the new year. I don't really want to put myself into one little fashion niche because, I don't know, evolving is fun. I like trying new things. So I hope you enjoyed this video. Thank you so much for watching it all the way to this part. Like, it really, really means the world to me, even watching it at all. That's so cool. Also, I've been posting a lot more on TikTok and Instagram if you want to go check me out on there. But if not, see you next time. Bye. Love you so much. C'est l'histoire d'une fille pas trop compliquée pour une fois. Cherchant l'impossible, elle trouva que c'était une bonne idée d'avancer.